So let's take a look at the use of operators to support range queries. Let me show you what I mean. MongoDB provides several inequality operators that enable us to perform this type of query. The inequality operators we may use include greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to, or not equal to. There are also a couple that are designed for querying array fields. We'll talk about those in a later lesson. Now let's look at some queries against our cities collection that provide examples of using inequality operators. Okay, so imagine that we want to query for all cities with a population greater than 250,000. Instead of specifying an exact number here as the value for our query document, which is going to be passed to find here, we're instead going to use the greater than operator, and the value of population in our query document is going to be a subdocument using that operator. We can specify a more constrained range for a query like this using an additional operator. Now this example is very similar to what we just looked at, the only difference being that in the value for population in our query document, we're specifying an additional operator of less than or equal to 500,000, thus defining a more constrained range for this query here. Now this type of range-based query works across many different data types. We can do something similar for strings. So here, the semantics of this range are, give us all city names that begin with X. Let's go ahead and run this code. And here we can see that in the results we get back, looks like we're getting back cities that just begin with the letter X. Total match of 22 cities out of the 20,000 or so that are in this collection. Okay, let's look at our code again. We can also do this type of query against dates. Here we're specifying a Python date as the lower and upper bound. And so here we're looking for all cities that have a founding date sometime in the year 1837. And actually, to be precise here, we should really have this be greater than or equal to. Okay, now let's run this. Okay, and we get three cities that match. We can see that the founding date here seems to be within range, as it is here, and also here for the city of Chicago. Finally, we can also do things like use the not equals operator to, for example, in this case, find all cities with a country that's not equal to the United States.